it on the edge.
It's even cooler thing. So you did a great job.
Thank you. So are you. This one up. We've got the chicken tractor all completed. I've actually had it out a couple times now, and it's real easy to hook up and put back. It only takes a couple minutes to prep it and get it ready to take out in the yard, and a couple minutes to put it back. So it's not a real big process. The watering system's finished now, so we're able to put about a gallon of water in the little pipe there with the chicken nipples, so they can have something to drink while they're out and about the yard. We've got the nesting box put in there in case they decide they need to lay an egg during the day. Then we're not trying to look in the grass and look for eggs. They like to have a place to go to do that. So that should work out pretty well. So far it's been great. And this will be really nice for them because they just absolutely love to have a fresh patch of ground to scratch around in. They'll find worms. Right now I've got them kind of parked over part of a little garden bed that we had a whole bunch of tomatoes, and there's tomato stuff all over the ground, and they're just going to town in there on that stuff, so they love it. So definitely something I would recommend if you're designing a chicken coop. You know, try to make part of it detachable, or make a small chicken tractor that you can herd the chickens into. You can get them out in your yard. They just absolutely love it. So if you guys have any questions or comments, please throw those down below. This pretty much wraps up the chicken tractor portion of the chicken coop building process here. I've only got a few more additions to do on the chicken coop, and I'll have videos posted for those. So hit thumbs up on this video. I really do appreciate it if you liked it or thought it was cool. Again, questions or comments, throw those down below. Thanks for watching. Have a good one.